Okay, so let's talk about how do we figure out if we have a function when we're given an example like this here where we're given a set, right? So if we have a set of ordered pairs, how do we figure out if it's a function or not? And then if it is, let's state the domain and range of it. So let's take a look at the first example that I have right here at the top. So first off, to figure out if it's a function, so the process actually is pretty simple for that. You're mainly concerned at looking at your x values. So here we have ordered pairs, right? And our x values are the ones in that first position. So do remember when we look at an ordered pair here, the first number is always an x value, the second number is always a y value. So when we're figuring out if it's a function, the main thing that we need to keep in our head is that our x values cannot repeat. So as long as we look through this here, and as long as none of these x values repeats, I don't have any of the same numbers. So pretty much as long as I look at these and they're all different numbers for the x position, then we're good. It's a function. We don't care about the y positions, not whenever we're dealing with is it a function or not. We really just care what the x values are, and we want to make sure that they do not repeat. So taking a look at this example, we have a 2, a 4, a 6, and an 8. None of those are the same. So yes, this is a function. Now we need to state the domain and range of it. So when it comes to domain, think of domain of the span of all of your x values. So your domain is just what x values do I have for that given problem. The range is your y values then. So if you look at a graph typically, so if you can picture these on a graph, right, your x values, that's looking left and right. So your x values, the x-axis is the horizontal one, whereas your y values is the vertical one. So scan left to right and see what you have for the domain, and for the range, you scan up and down. With ordered pairs here, stating the domain is just a matter of listing everything in the x position. So our domain is made up of a 2, a 4, a 6, and an 8, and that's it. Those four points right there, those four values, is our domain. For the range, that means that we're just going to look at our y values. So for our y values, we have a negative 2, a negative 4, a negative 6, and a negative 4. So that is our range there. So let's take a look at the second example then, and let's start off with, is it a function? So take a look at your x values. All right, so 1, 2, 1, negative 2. So pay close attention here. So hopefully you notice that here. So we have this 1 here that repeated. And if it's a function, we cannot have an x value repeat. So for this one, this is a no. No, it is not a function. And if it's not a function, we normally don't state the domain and range of it. It's not a function, so we're pretty much done with that one. So this is how you find out if it's a function or not when given a set of ordered pairs.